Hey everybody, it's Kayla Troutman, Wildtree Director. It is July 5th, coming to you after the holiday weekend, and we are doing our Wildtree 2.0, our leadership group. This is our fifth call. It's actually our sixth week. Last week, I blew the call off for a baseball game and beer, and I think everybody understood. So thank you for your grace in that, friends. It was a big month. I had a lot to close, and I needed those beers. So thank you for understanding. Plus, we're starting the 30-day clean eating challenge. And of course, the time's out. We're like, I'm going to have to be better than normal at conference. So I needed that night last week. So tonight, we're going to be reviewing one quick time so you can hear out of my mouth the referral process that we're using to try to grow our businesses quicker when maybe we can't be doing 100 parties a month. And I know for someone like Jenna, this is great. I know for some of you that, you know, don't maybe have 15 events on your calendar each month. Not that I would tell you that you want 15 events anyway, but you get the point. Like if you can't do that, this is a great way to grow your business just as fast in some ways as doing a party, but from the comfort of your home. So we're going to review that. We're going to, talk a little bit again about daily activity, and then we're going to leave the rest for open forum, which I had promised you guys last week and we never got to. So just chatting a little bit about Facebook groups, growing your customer base, whatever you guys need. So we're going to jump right in really quick. Tell us your name. Every time say your name. I probably don't have to tell you that anymore, but it's important because then people learn your face and your name. Some exciting news you have going on, and like take a minute or two and share your deep, dark belly, why you're wild train right now. We haven't done that yet. Jenna, we do something different each time. Sometimes it's how did your homework go? Sometimes it's all different things. But tonight I want name, something exciting. It can be life or it can be business. And then your deep, dark belly, why Wildtree, starting out with July? Like, why are you here? Whoever wants to go first, rock it out.
I'll go.
Okay, perfect.
Well, I'm Danny. This week, so in June, I had a couple parties have to reschedule. But it actually turned out, I'm kind of excited. The week after we come back from conference, I have 4 parties. So that's kind of like my big thing right now. I think that's pretty cool to have them all in 1 week. It's going to be hectic, but I'm going to love it. And then, so Wildtree for me, it was student loans, and now I might need a new vehicle. So it's going to hopefully help with that. Might also be helping start putting a down payment, getting that ready for a house. So a lot of different things, definitely the extra income right now, and I'm loving meeting everybody. So bonus.
Awesome. Thank you, Danny. I muted myself in between as well. So awesome. Thank you for sharing.
I can go. Hi guys. I'm Jenna, newbie here. I'm not new to Wildtree though. I've been doing Wildtree for almost 2.5 years and didn't start taking it seriously until conference last year, which was amazing. Super excited to go back this year. But right now, my current why for Wildtree is that we are expecting baby number 3 in December, and we want to pay off some specific debt before that happens. So my husband just started a brand new job as well, so I kind of took a back seat with Wildtree during that season, and so now vamping up and getting ready to go and start over again. So here we go.
Awesome. Love it, friend. I didn't know that your baby was due in December. What's the due date?
December 15th.
Oh, fun. Macaulay was born the 12th, but I was due the 5th. So okay. Very, very fun. Cool. Congratulations.
Yeah. Thank you.
Awesome.
All right, I will go. Some exciting news in my life, I guess. I just went to my brother and sister-in-law's gender reveal party last weekend, and they found out that they're having a little boy, so that was some exciting things going on around here. And then why am I here? I am with Wildtree because I will be student teaching in the fall and won't be able to really work a full-time position or even a part-time position other than Wildtree. So I'm hoping to really just get this rolling, and hopefully that will supplement our income here in the summer and fall, and hopefully moving forward.
Love it. Thank you, Ashley. And then Tabitha, I don't know if you can talk or not. So if you can't, just want to type quick. Okay, there she goes. She's talking. She says, hi, I'm Tabitha. Something exciting going on in my life. I just lost the chain. Is that we are looking into buying a house and planning for baby number 5. I'm doing Wildtree to work towards not having to go back to work after baby. So really quick, I know Tabitha well, so I can just add to this. Her main Wildtree why is she does not like her job. It's a bad situation. And the house and the family is just another reason. This sounds crazy, right? Like that's not reason enough, but she's already been working towards leadership so that she can in the next year or two have that income to back herself up and not have to go back to work. And now they've obviously decided to jump in and even have more of a Wildtree why. So awesome. If anybody else watches this recording, why I ask, yeah, no problem, Tabitha, I got your back. I understand. Tabitha also had the craziest training call ever with me last week. I think that was last week. Yeah. A week and a couple days ago where I lost my baby monitor. And then I had to do the training call as I was on my way to Target to buy a new baby monitor. So poor Tabitha, she's just been through the ringer with me lately. But what I want you guys to hear, if you're listening to the recording or if you're on live, and I just told Jenna this today too, when we chatted, is that like, if you don't have a Wildtree why that makes you do the work, you're just not going to reach your potential here. So the number one why I want you, or the thing I want you to take away from this call tonight is literally, if you have a strong why, Ashley, you have a strong why. You have to provide financial means. So like you have to get rid of all of the, I'd like to make money here. I think I could make money here. If I could make the money here, I wouldn't have to find another job. I don't know what else I would do because there's nothing else that matches my hours. So I'm hoping Wildtree can be this. You have to get rid of all of that. And you just have to make this, like in your mind, this is your solution. Because I will tell you guys, that's the difference. Like when I came into Wildtree, I wasn't going to do this. If I was just going to be like one party a month here or there, it just didn't seem like that was valuable enough for my family. Because to be honest, even one event a month, like just seemed like noise. I didn't need the money, right? So I had to find a different why. And so my why became like, okay, if I can do a couple of things, I can be this team leader. And that makes me feel really important. And I get free products and I'm making about $1,000 a month. So then it seems worth it to me. Pays for CrossFit, our groceries, and it was paying off things so that we knew we could sell our house, right? And then eventually, like I just got good at that. And within a year, I basically was a steady team leader to where I was like, I could easily make $2,000 a month. And then that became my why because $2,000 a month covered our new mortgage. Like, so bottom line is like, I've had a strong why the whole time, even though in the beginning I didn't need the money. I just did a training meeting on Monday here at my house. And Melissa, she's going to watch this call back. I'm sure she's in this group. She said to me, well, I don't actually need the money. And immediately I stopped that language. So I'm not picking on you, Ashley. It's all of you in this group. Please work really hard right now on setting your language up so that you believe this is the solution and you believe you can make that money. Because you can make good money this month. You're the only thing stopping yourself. You might think it's, you know, lack of parties, lack of contacts. You don't have a customer base like Kayla. You're not as outgoing. You don't know how to sell the products, all this stuff. But really it's you. Because if you want it bad enough, I'm proof you can do it. I didn't know anything about Wildtree. My first few parties, I remember literally looking at them when they would ask me a question about sugar or sodium. I had no effing idea where to even find that stuff. You guys have those resources. So just know, like, you right now have to say, okay, we've been doing this a couple weeks. We've been setting ourselves up for success. No more excuses. You're going big or you're going home. In Ashley's case, she needs to make money so that she doesn't go broke when she's student teaching. Like, and this hopefully then will be something that she can do alongside her teaching someday. We've got Sarah on the team who's rocking it out, top in sales every month, being a full-time teacher. Like there's all these cool things that this can be. But if you don't start giving yourself that pep talk in the morning and setting your strong vision or your why, nothing I train you on going forward from now on is going to matter. Okay. So everybody just, that's number one this week. You're going to work on your language and belief. And if your spouse is like beating up on the idea, like, I don't know that, but if any of you have that, that's okay. Like your job is not to convince him or them. It's to show them by a paycheck or by the results. So just stop worrying about convincing people and only worry about yourself believing this can happen and then doing the work. And I can help you with the work part, but I can't help you with the belief part. You have to get that yourself. Okay. So then going, thank you all for sharing a little bit. So going into the review of last week or 2 weeks ago, I'm going to go really fast, but I want to say it again so you can hear me if you're like an audio learner, because we didn't record that call. So we are talking about referrals and how you can grow your business really fast. If you have people in front of you and you can ask them who else they know. And also if you reach out to somebody and they say they're not interested right now, whether you were looking to sell them some products, whether you were looking to share the business opportunity, whatever, you can say to them, oh, I totally get it. What I'm hearing is you're super busy. If it's okay with you, I'll add you to my maybe later list and I'll follow up with you in the future. Is that a dog or a cat, Ashley? I have to know. Okay, there's the little dog. It was just funny because it was just a little glimpse. Sorry, I'm really squirrel. I probably shouldn't even look at the video screen.
No, I was laughing because I could see her little tail in the screen, and I was wondering if you guys could see it too.
Yes. It's cute. Okay, so a referral lead is where, again, I was just in the middle of that. Sorry about being so squirrely tonight. But basically, if you're at checkout with someone or you're on the phone with someone and you're asking them to either join your team or book a party and they're saying no, you can, of course, add them to your maybe later list. And then you can say something like, thank you for being so honest. If all of my customers just shared with me that right now is not a great time, I would be so grateful. So you're going to transition out of what you were working on, compliment, or lead with something kind like that, and then move into the who do you know. So by transition, I mean all of your checkout is done, your payment's accepted, or you booked them, or you asked them to join your team. You know, if you're at a checkout, you're doing all the steps. But if you're on the phone and you're asking them to book and they say no, that might be all that you needed. Like, that might be time to transition. You're going to compliment them in some way if you can, or you're going to offer them something. If they say to you, if they say to Ashley, Ashley, you know what? I would love to book with you in fall. Can you follow up with me then? Right now I'm struggling with babysitters and I just have a lot on my plate and my sitters keep canceling and I just can't think about anything besides that. Ashley might know some young people in the area that babysit and she might be able to say, hey, when we hang up, I'll check in with them and see if they're available this summer and I'll send you those numbers. And that person's going to say to you, oh, that would be awesome. And then you're going to say, Ashley, who do you know by chance that has a garden this summer? Or who do you know that's a busy mom just like you with little ones at home? Who do you know that's that super busy family that literally every time you go on Instagram, they're somewhere fun, way cooler than your life? Who has allergy or dietary needs? You know, you're going to roll into the who do you know. So you're going to transition, compliment them, or offer them a service or something else that you have that's going to save them some kind of time, money, whatever, and then move into the who do you know. Never say referral. Never say, do you know? You are saying, who do you know? And if they give you names, you're going to write them down with a phone number. That's all you need, name and phone number. And then after you get a couple, because usually you're going to say, and anyone else? Or who else? Anyone else that you know that has little kids? Oh, yeah. Oh, does she have a friend too that you know? It sounded like in that story you did. Because of course, they're not just going to say the name, right? They're going to probably tell you a little background about them. And then after you get a couple, you can even say, hey, any chance you have a fun fact you could tell me about these people? The most information you need is name, number, fun fact. The least information you need, name and number. And you can drill them as many as they'll give you. If you're me, Kayla, you give a lot of referrals because you naturally talk a lot and you talk about friends because you love people. And so naturally, the other day when someone practiced this skill on me, I didn't even realize it, but as conversation continued after they tried to get referrals, I was like giving more people's names and talking about more of my friends, and they were writing that down. So if you have someone like that, you're going to get a ton of referrals. You might have Sally that comes to check out and she gives you one or two, and then that seems like that's all she wants to give you. That's okay. Shut up and listen, write down what they give you, and move on. That is it. That is the skill. It is super easy. It's going very well for me. And if that seems like, oh my gosh, that's nerve-wracking, then if you're in my organization, and Jenna, I can send this to you if you remind me to send it to you. I'm not very good at remembering. In my newsletter I sent out this month, you guys, on the first, you should have gotten an attachment on there that was for referrals. Two pages, one more towards recruiting, one more towards sales. And so that should be able to kind of lead into the referral conversation. So how you would use that sheet, if you didn't see it, go back to the newsletter. It's titled, if you want to search your emails, July 1st, it had all of our stats. And there's an attachment. And what you would do is you'd print that out and you'd have that to give to your guests when you give them a catalog. And what you could say is, for anyone that brings this up with names and numbers on it, I'm going to give you a free sample. Or you could do, I'm going to put your name in a drawing tonight, and after the party's over, I'm going to pick a full-size product to give away. I don't care. But if you end up with 20 referrals, that's like having the 8 people that were at the party and 20 more people there. that's pretty incredible. So the point would be you'd have those sheets, you would give it to them, and then hopefully they would fill them out for you. Some people do referrals that way better because it's more comfortable and it makes the checkout process a little bit faster. I'm sure some of you are wondering how on earth with 5 people at a party or 10 people at a party, you would sit and have this lengthy of a conversation. And I know Sonara has told me too, like she's in some party cases not even done good checkout lately because people are just that busy. So then having that sheet would mean that they could leave that at checkout and you'd still have referrals to follow up with the next day. Any questions about any of that? I just wanted it to be recorded and I wanted it to be on here. Even if you start getting a couple referrals a week, you guys, that's people that you don't have in your system right now. It's people that you don't have in your customer base. Like referrals are huge. It's free growth and you don't have to go sit at a vendor fair all day to get 10 contacts. You don't have to like do an extra 2 parties a month to meet 20 extra people. Like you could literally do that by just asking people who they know, especially the people you know right now that you feel like have just ordered and they're not interested in hosting. Ask them who they know. Especially when it comes to the business, because some of you have shared that you're struggling with getting recruit leads and it might be an age thing. It might be the season of life your friends are in. And not all of you have been doing this long enough where like they're starting to see the wealth you're creating and they're starting to see you and say, oh my gosh, I want to do what Ashley's doing. She's been doing this a long time. It may be time for you then to reach out to those friends and say, who do you know? And sometimes when their friends start to join, they'll join along with them. So there's my tip on referrals. Okay. Anything? I'm going to go here so I can see all of you. Any questions? It's a huge way to grow your business. Okay. Then daily activity. Let's just do a really quick review on this because this also was not recorded. I just want to quickly say, so if you are trying to make the most of this business and you need to make money fast and you want your business to grow, you need to be going for reach outs every day until you literally feel like you have no one to reach out to or talk to. And please remember too, when I reach out to people who I reach out to on Monday, if I don't hear back from them, I'm reaching out again on Thursday. So when I take the number of people that I'm reaching out to in a week, it's not like you guys, I reach out to 5 or 10 people a day that are brand new. I'm reaching out to 5 or 10 people a day, but then at the end of the week, I'm recycling back through those same people, following up with people who haven't gotten back to me. And a lot of times it just simply sounds like, hey, Sally, I had messaged you on Monday. I know how busy life is and it's my job to just check in with you and make sure that you did get my message and that you don't need any help right now with recipes and that you're loving your freezer meals. So when I look at my daily reach out activity, 5-ish a day for a leader, 10-ish a day for a director is pretty normal. But again, it's not all new people. You're rolling people through. That can be a hostess. That can be a teammate. That can be just customer care, and it can also be people that you're reaching out to cold referrals. So 5 to 10 a day is the activity level that if you really want your business to grow, you should be doing. Actually having dialogue with 1 to 3 a day, even a week, to be honest, is really good because let's be real, people are busy enough. I'm sure, shake your head if you feel this way. You reach out to 20 and you hear from no one, right? Yeah. Okay. That's totally normal. We all experience it. So if you can get 1 to 3 to chat with you, like that is great. You should write that down. And if you guys like have a notebook and you can just kind of track this for the next couple weeks, we can look at the end of July one-on-one. I'll never embarrass you in a group setting like this, but we can look at the end of the month and see if you hit these numbers and you don't feel like you grew like astronomically, then we need to make sure what you're saying is good. Does that make sense? Sometimes you can be doing the work, but if you're not quite reaching them where they're at, then you're missing the boat. So it's two parts. It's doing the actual workload and then making sure you're doing what needs to be done. Exactly how right now in 2017, in July, people need to be reached. Dated parties, you're trying to do 4 to 6 a month if you can, 6 to 10 for a director, if you can, live, Zoom, Facebook, I don't care, but that's a really good rate. Parties ran, you're booking 4 to 6 and 6 to 10, and you're hoping to hold a minimum of 4 for a leader and 8 for a director. That doesn't always happen like that. You guys know that if you can do 6 or 8, Ashley, I don't know what your schedule will look like, but like I can tell you 5 or 6 for you to make like some full-time income here. Like you could literally make as much as you're going to start out teaching with Wildtree side by side at the same time. But to do that, I think you're going to have to up the number of days that you're working right now. And P.S. I'm saying that without knowing how many parties you have scheduled. And Danny, I don't know your schedule either, but just telling you guys, like you can make some really good money with doing a few more than 4 a month if you can, but minimum 4. Dated one-on-ones, you're trying to date, whether it's a phone, Zoom, or live one-on-one appointment/menu planning consultation, 1 to 3. a month and you're trying to run 1 to 2. It'd be even better if you did per week, but a month is good. It's just another version. I mean, sometimes you guys, I've had a one-on-one that ordered $330 and I never had to leave my house. I talked to her on the phone for a half hour and like that was better than going to a party. Granted, you don't meet new people that way, but if you do the referral process, she could give you a few names. And then at the end of the day, it was just like having a party. Does that make sense to everybody? Okay. Now, P.S., if it's a professional, they're not going to be turned off by the referral questions. In fact, they're expecting that. Think about how many times, like if you ever used Mary Kay back in the day, I don't know if you guys have Mary Kay rep now, the vacuum people that come door to door, book salesmen that come door to door. I mean, tons of things. Car people, they're always asking you to pass the name along. Real estate is huge. How do you think real estate agents grow? Referrals. So just know this is not uncommon. It's just something WildTree's not good at teaching us yet. It's coming. Okay, sales a week, 500 to 1,000 is a really good goal because that means that you're going to minimum sell 2,000. Raise your hand if you don't at least want to sell that. That's what I thought. Everybody wants to sell that because that team leader pay, that's $800 right there. If you sell 2,000, the more the merrier. 2 to 4 recruits added and connect somehow, trying to get 5 referrals a week if you can. That's really easy if you have a party because you should literally be able to walk out of a party with 5 referrals. So I will post this in the notes. That's a lot of information I just spouted off, but I just wanted to be able to quickly share that. And again, I'll post the callback from tonight and I'll post this one more time so you guys have it. It varies for each person. There's no exact set. People asked me this tonight on orientation call. Well, how many parties did you do when you earned Costa Rica and you worked full-time? Because you guys all know this on this call, right? I worked full-time the entire time I earned Costa Rica. I did not quit my job until I was going to Costa Rica, which the earning period had been over then for 4 months. And I looked at, like, I really looked at my husband and I'm like, how many parties did I do a month when I was working full time? He's like, oh, jeepers, you never are consistent. I wasn't consistent with the number. I was consistent with always working. Sometimes your life is going to be busy and you're not going to do a party a week. It just doesn't make logical sense. Does it really make sense on the 4th of July weekend for me to do a party? No, my husband was off. So I haven't done any parties the first week of July and I won't. I've got 2 next week and then I have a big break again because of conference. That's just how I planned it out. That's okay. You don't have to be super consistent in that. Jenna, you can match this around your family. Danny, you can match this around, you know, your fun activities and things you have going on at your age. I feel like an old lady. But you have to be consistent in the sense that you're shooting for that goal. So it has to average out, right, to 4 to 6 a month. But if you're going to do a mystery box sale and you've got a plan for a maternity leave, Jenna, I can help you with that, especially in December. I think December is the best month to have maternity leave, in my unbiased opinion, of course. But seriously, it rocked. I had an awesome December. Recruited, booked everything for January, February while I was home. It was wonderful. But if you can set yourself up, then you don't have to leave the house either. I just want to say that, but you have to be consistent. There were months in my 2 years of working full-time, I left the house 1 time. And then there were some months that I left the house 10 times. Double hostess credits are always high. And I always worked really hard in January because I never went to leadership. And a little part of me wanted to outdo everybody that did, kind of like a jab, like, yeah, you take the time to go to leadership and I'm going to work harder than you. And my sales are going to be better. And my paycheck's going to be better. Well, you're off having fun without me. So that's just kind of how I rolled. Now I go to leadership, but long story short, P.S. you all should plan on leadership this year. It's in Vegas. Who doesn't want to go to Vegas? I'm just saying, I've never been to Vegas, so I'm pretty excited about that. Okay, that's all I have for that, the topic. Who has questions? Or I wanted to ask you guys, how are you feeling about progress and or your Facebook group / customer base growing? Did you guys get anybody in the 30-day challenge group? Like, what's holding you up or what are you celebrating? Whatever you have, go. I will stop talking. Drink my tea.
I actually have a question. Kind of, I have my first one-on-one next week. So okay. I guess just looking for some tips on how to go about setting that up. Like, where do you kind of start? Because she has an old workshop that she didn't end up getting to make because she got sick. And then they've been kind of using the products every now and then. So I've got to kind of come up with recipes with the product she has, but then also want to figure out how to incorporate other stuff too. So I'm just not sure exactly where to start on that.
Sure. Are you meeting her?
Yes. I'm going okay. to the house because she said her husband likes to cook too. So it's going to be like the 3 of us.
Perfect. Okay. I would tell you first off to try to make sure that you respect your time. So don't set it up like you're going to be there for 5 hours, right? Because that's like not smart for you. But it'll be really good practice. No, too, whatever comes of it, this is going to be really good because you're going to get it out of the way the first one. Just kind of like when we launch our business and how crappy that first party can be or how awesome. We just never know. It's a 50-50 shot. Same thing when you go to your first one-on-one and your first referral conversation as well. Could be a total dud. I'm just going to warn you. Or it could be really awesome. But get it out of the way. I want to ask Ashley, Tabitha, or Jenna if they want to first say how they would walk into that. So she has products. It sounds like you're going there with the intention of helping her. And obviously you want to set the tone that this is a lifestyle. So you're going to want her to order. I mean, that's something we all want. So, or host, depending. Who has a thought? Ashley or Jenna, Cheryl or Tabitha?
I was just thinking, does she have enough product to use? Because you said it was a workshop, right?
Yeah.
So does she have enough product to use to make the recipes that she already has in the workshop, and then more, maybe she can order more of the same product to use to make some of those recipes?
I'm thinking that's where I'll have to start, is see where, like you said, see how much she has left and go from there. So,
Jenna, do you have a thought? Otherwise, I'm going to go. Yep, Jenna.
Yeah, I would probably ask her what kind of meals they like, if they're crock pot. If assuming you don't know what the kit is, if it's like an all-girl one or a crock pot one, then obviously you know they're leaning towards that. But definitely figuring out what kinds of foods their family eats and if they do have dietary restrictions would be, for me, a good starting point to kind of figure out where to direct the conversation.
Well, and I know when I talked to her, she did have, her husband is allergic to onion. So that, the onion-free list that we have somewhere in the group.
Yep. Awesome. Okay. So what I would say is just like that. Start it out with a positive introduction. Oh my gosh, it looks like you have some knowledge of WildTree. You know, let me just quickly give you, if it's okay with you, I do a lot more asking permission in a small setting, because if they say they don't care, then why even bother kind of thing. But just share a little bit about WildTree, the health benefits, obviously share that you can meet her dietary need of onion free, that kind of language. And then you're going to set them up like, okay, so I know you have your workshop bundle. So I'm going to first focus on that. Let's look at what you have here and how simple it's going to be to put it together. And obviously I'm assuming she's not putting it together while you're there. I'm assuming she's going to do it after the fact, but if she's doing it there, great. I mean, that won't take long at all. But if not, then you're going to say like, here's what we're going to do. I would take a blank calendar. You know, I do this at my parties. I would have them write in their 10 busiest days, write those meals in, help them with some ideas for the leftovers. And honestly, I would find out what bundle it is and just take the use it up sheet and print that out. Like, I would totally cheat. Why come up with random ideas? And then I always share the naked protein recipe. And then I say, okay, let's look through the book here and pick a few, because if this get you guys, she spent this money a while ago now. You have to have the assumption she's going to purchase something. You're going to help her, but then you're also going to go in with the, let's look through the book here and find some other pantry staples that would be even easier to use on all the nights that you don't have a meal now planned with the leftover products or the dinners. And then I would move into like either having the fresh sheet, Danny, which is one page, or the replace the state, like whatever sheet you want, one sheet that just shows fast options and a catalog. So very simple format, but then you're going to have her create a wish list. You'll have an order form. And then obviously you're just going to write in those items as you look through. Like, do you think the kids' cheese is a good fit for your family? Oh, I don't know, Danny. I mean, they kind of love Kraft. Okay, no problem. I totally get it. You can't change everything in your family at one time. What about, like we talked earlier about some homemade pizzas or some of our sauces? Like if they say they love to grill, like Jenna's point, then lead them to the barbecue sauces between the Korean and we have the new sweet plum, all the different options. Like you could sell them $50 worth of sauces, easy, if they love that kind of stuff. So it's going to totally be based on what you learn from them as you talk through the kit that they have. Absolutely. But I would take the use it up sheet and give them ideas to use all their leftover products. Now, if they already broke into their WildTree and everything's not brand new, then to Ashley's point, you're going to fill out that order form, replace the things that they already used too much of so they can make all 10 meals, and then add to that. And of course, try to sell them the make fresh bundle, because it sounds like they need recipes. It sounds like they're a family where if it doesn't come spelled out, they might not use it. So maybe go with the make fresh bundle too. But that's how simple I would keep it. Very casual. But to the point that you're expecting an order. Now, sometimes when you finish up, they'll say, well, we need to like keep looking. Can we get back to you tomorrow? Absolutely. Of course, you're not going to pressure them. But if they don't say that. Like they may, so this is where I think sometimes our limiting self-talk, right? Ashley, I'm picking on you a lot tonight. Her, I really want this to work. I hope this works. This can be where at the checkout, then you're not confident enough to say, why wouldn't they place this order? Like I just helped them. I showed them how they're going to use it. It's going to take 2 weeks to get. In the meantime, they can be making their freezer meals they have. And then this is going to come in and this is going to be the next step. That's how you need to advertise it, Danny, and you need to have that much confidence. When my Mary Kay rep came here last, I had no intention of buying anything. I literally was just like having her come over because she's a Wildtree customer and we had swapped parties and all this stuff. I left, like she left with like a $250 order, but I seriously loved everything I got. Then I got introduced to LeBry and you guys know the story, but long story short, like she was really good. She didn't make me feel pressured either, but she was really good at showing me for my skin what I was telling her. Busy mom, no time to put on makeup. I love lipstick. I think I got 16 lipsticks, literally. Like, seriously, though, like, you have to have that assumption and that confidence. That's a great question. Is that good? Does that give you enough to go on?
Yep, this is a lot of good stuff.
Okay, who else has a question or something they want to share?
The other thing I was going to say is that last week, the firework image that you shared with like the 1 through 9 was really helpful for me because it helped me or allowed me to actually follow up with some of the people that were interested in booking parties. So it allowed me to kind of follow up with them because they were interested in one of the 1 to 9 options. And yeah, I don't know if anyone else used that, but that was really helpful for me last week.
Good, 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 good.
I didn't use it this time, but I know I used it for Easter and it worked out really well for me too.
Yeah, I think I'm guilty of never sharing it well like I did this time. I actually posted it. I could have made, after I posted it in the group, I actually added a bunch of American flag emojis and I made it all really cute and like whatever, my little like responses I sent out. I should have did the updated one to all you, but I'm trying to get better. Like if I do it, if I'm doing it anyway, why don't I just share it in our team page so you all have it? So I'm really working on trying to be duplicatable faster because I'm doing it. I just don't think about it because it's another notification for all of you, like number 17 from me in the same day. So I try to be aware of that.
Yeah, I was just going to say thank you for doing that because that was super helpful because I was kind of going back to Sam because initially I didn't see what you had posted and I'm like, well, how do you do this? And, you know, what do you have a list of what 1 to 9 is? And she's like, no, you kind of just figure out, you know, what's going to work best for each person and what's going to work best for you. And then I looked at what you had posted and kind of picked through, you know, what would work best for people. So that was really helpful.
Awesome. Okay, good. Anyone else have a question or something else?
I'd gone back to Sam on my first one too. I was like, yep. What are these? How does it work?
Yep. Yeah. Lots of. Yeah, lots of confusion around that. Hold on, I see Tabitha's typing us something. She says, I have a potential customer that's concerned with maltodextrin and natural flavor lists in some of the products. How would you respond? Tabitha, I would probably call field sales services on the specifics. Jenna maybe even has experience in this. I don't get that many questions about that specific. Like, even though I ate strict paleo and I literally was 30 pounds less than I am to date, I never, like, I mean, I criticize the product somewhat with the maltodextrin. I would even comment like, oh shoot, we probably shouldn't have that in our product, but it's small amounts. And I know Wildtree is the best of the best. I can't probably answer that any better than you either calling field sales services or maybe Jenna knows a better resource. No, she's saying no. I don't really have anybody that questions that deeply. Now, it's not that we don't have an answer. I just don't know it. So if you're not in the Idea Factory, I would first search maltodextrin there. And then otherwise I would call field sales services and ask them if there's someone you can ask or if there's a resource. Otherwise search the resource center too, of course. But we do have maltodextrin in a few of our products. And if you are paleo and if you eat certain ways, it's actually not allowed in the diet if they're strict. Or they could have an allergy, I guess, but it's normally just somebody, don't take this the wrong way, being a little crazy, but it's true. I was that crazy person that did CrossFit for 3 years. Now I'm the complete opposite. Like, not crazy at all. Want to eat noodles? Eat noodles. Doesn't matter. Like, just do whatever you got to do to survive. Seriously. Okay. Who else? Anybody else? Tabitha's laughing at me. I mean, I don't mean like eat bad. Obviously, I need the 30-day challenge for a reason, though. Like, seriously, went complete extremes in my life. Complete extremes. Anyone else? Okay. Last tip. Your homework's going to be really simple. It's going to be practicing positive self-talk and really getting it in your head that, like, you're going to make Wildtree work. You're going to promote to team leader. You're going to promote to team leader fast. So get your butts in gear. And then number 2 is, like, you're literally going to be do the work. Figure it out. If you need help, like Jenna and I had a great conversation today. She's busy. She's got 2 kids, crazy husband schedule. Like, so she completely understands Nate's schedule. And it's like, you can't make excuses. You have to just play. It's trial and error, but you have to do the work. And honestly, like, I'm just going to tell you from just now mimicking a few other business plans. I've been paying attention to Pampered Chef. I've been paying attention to Tupperware. I've been paying attention